what's up, guys? A little bit of a unique episode of NOMAD this week. A couple of weeks ago, of course, I went down to Knoxville, Tennessee, and I also did some hiking while I was down there. So that was going to be this week's episode, me hiking through the Smoky Mountains just outside of Gatlinburg, Tennessee. However, last night, wildfires ripped through that whole area and evacuated thousands. It's a really terrifying situation. When you see some of the videos from down there, when I woke up today, and at first I said, I'm not gonna put together a NOMAD where I'm kind of joking around walking through the Smoky Mountains. And then a bunch of my listeners who live down there wanted to alert me of what was going on because they said it wasn't getting a lot of national attention because of everything that's happening in politics right now. So I figured this could be a good opportunity to draw some attention to what's going on in Pigeon Forge and Gatlinburg, Tennessee. I actually went down there with my family a number of times growing up. We just love the mountains and love Dollywood. And just so you know, there is ways that you can help. If you're in that area, there's a bunch of different organizations looking for food and water. If you're outside of that area and want to donate food or water, or just donate money, you can do that as well through the Red Cross and other organizations. This is the place where you get a full list of what you can do and where you can do it. I don't mean for this to come off as flippant, me joking around in the mountains as they burn right now, but just wanted to show you the area and the beauty and the majesty of what is right now dealing with raging forest fires because of 3 months of drought and now high winds that's helping spread it all. So in many ways, consider this my love letter to the Great Smoky Mountains, which are some of the most beautiful scenery we have in this country, and a place that's very close to my heart. Just remember, you can help out the area that's in the time of need right now, and I will certainly be doing so today also. Epic surroundings. I'm in the Great Smoky Mountains, right on the Tennessee and North Carolina state border. This is called Newfound Gap Trail. Up here, this is where the Appalachian Trail actually crosses. Check it out. It's beautiful up here, man. Absolutely beautiful. This is about an hour and a half outside of Knoxville, down towards Dollywood, home of Dolly Parton, and Pigeon Forge and Gatlinburg, which is just the big tourism towns right at the edge of the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. We're up near the highest point of the Great Smoky Mountains, Clingman's Dome. It's more than 6,600 feet up. The views just keep getting more and more ridiculous. Up to Clingman's Dome. It's pretty high up here. A little shortness of breath. And when I got out of the car, definite headache. I saw a guy with a throwback Dan Marino jersey over at the parking lot, which is just amazing. Imagine saying, yeah, I want to go on a big hike today. Let's go to the highest point of the Smoky Mountains. What should I wear? How about my throwback Merino jersey? Well, that certainly makes me feel better. If a toddler can do this, I can. And maybe even Merino throwback guy can. No wonder Tebow won a playoff game. Who could play football at this elevation? You know, if the Titans were smart, they'd sign Tebow and then play their playoff games up here at Clingman's Dome. That's the recipe for the Titans in the Super Bowl, even with Mike Mularkey as the head coach. Man, I saw like 25 Shoney's on the way in. If you stopped at Shoney's for breakfast or grabbed an egg and sausage and cheese biscuit from the Flying J truck stop, I don't know how you're doing this. I would just have a heart attack on the way up if I just had like Shoney's home fries and gravy just cooking right in here. I would just collapse. The
this whole construction looks exactly like something out of Planet Endor. Shouldn't like the park rangers be Ewoks? I feel like once you get to the top, you should be banging on stormtrooper helmets and dancing on a campfire. Warming up a little bit now in the middle of the afternoon, and I got jeans on. I'm gonna move into my cargo shorts. The problem is I don't want to do this outside the car because there's families around. The last thing I need is for somebody to be like, "Hey, that guy's flashing my kids. What do you think you're doing, son? I don't need to see you and your skivvies." Figure better safe than sorry. My six-year-old just got a whole eye full of your underwear. Just imagine an old lady. Oh, Lord. Please deliver him from his evil. He knows not of what he does. He thinks this is just one big bathroom. Sweet baby Jesus, please forgive the New Yorker for what he does not know. He believes the whole Smoky Mountain Range is one big change room at Urban Outfitters.
The one thing I love about hiking down here is that everybody says hi to you on the path. What you don't realize is that I grew up in the woods. We were actually one of the last houses on a long road backed up against a state park. So I grew up climbing on rocks and climbing up trees and climbing in a stream and climbing a lot of places I probably shouldn't have been climbing. So this is second nature for me. One thing I didn't realize is that air pollution's a pretty big deal around here. Apparently a lot of air pollution comes in from the Rust Belt and then up from the bayou where all the oil drilling, and it gets caught up here in the mountains because not a lot of space for it to move through, which means we need less refineries pumping out all that smoke and way less cow farts. That's the big one. If we could just figure out a way scientifically to prevent cows from farting, I think that'd be a big environmental win. Like, we have all types of weird vegetables and fruits and dogs that we crossbreed to find ways to make a better species. Why can't we just crossbreed some type of non-farting animal with a cow? It's so mind-blowing to think that if I just kept walking this Appalachian Trail, I would eventually get to Maine. But before that, I would get home. Where I grew up in Warwick, New York, my actual house is only about a 10-minute drive from where the Appalachian Trail actually crosses. Are there barbecue joints on the trail? I got football, I got barbecue, and I got the Smokies. Now that's the Nomad trifecta.
You know, if people didn't see your phone, they'd think you're standing there talking to yourself.
Exactly right. I'm sure a lot of people think I'm crazy. The best part about this is there's multiple people looking at me like I'm absolutely nuts. I'm just going to tell them it's the altitude. Remember to subscribe. There's a brand new episode of Nomad each and every week. Remember to take care of our national parks. How? Find a cure for the cow farts. We'll be right back.